how phenothiazines act. So first of all, let us see the classification of the phenothiazines. So phenothiazines are classified based on the side chain present at the 10th position. They may be classified as phenothiazines with alkyl side chain, piperidinyl side chain, as well as piperazinyl side chain. So the drugs in the alkyl side chain include chlorpromazine and trifluoprazine. Similarly, piperidinyl side chain include thioridazine and mesoridazine. Piperazinyl side chain include prochlorperazine, trifluoperazine, perphenazine and fluphenazine. You can observe that the piperazinyl side chain are having perazine or phenazine as the suffix, and alkyl side chain will have the promazine as the suffix. How these drugs act? These drugs show different types of actions, and one of the actions is the antipsychotic action, and second one anti-emetic action, and third one anticholinergic action, and fourth one antihistamine action, and finally they can also show the other types of actions. So let us start with the first one, antipsychotic action. Dopamine is one of important mediator within the CNS, which can act through the different dopaminergic pathways. So one of the pathways is the nigrostriatal pathway, and second is the mesolimbic pathway, and third is the mesocortical pathway, and fourth one is the tuberohypophyseal pathway. Now the dopamine acts on this mesolimbic and mesocortical pathway to produce the psychotic symptoms. In psychosis, the excessive dopamine levels are increased in the mesolimbic and mesocortical pathways. Now this raised dopamine levels can act on D2 receptors within these pathways, thereby they produce the symptoms like hallucinations, delusions and other types of psychotic symptoms. Now these phenothiazines are going to act as antagonists on these D2 receptors, thereby they produce antipsychotic action. Second type of action is the anti-emetic action of the phenothiazines. Some of the chemicals, bitters and anti-cancer agents can stimulate one of the important center in the CNS, that is the chemoreceptor trigger zone, which responds to the chemicals in the blood. Now this chemoreceptor trigger zone is equipped with two types of receptors. One is the 5-HT3 receptors and another is the D2 receptors, dopamine receptors. Once this chemoreceptor trigger zone is activated, then it sends the signals to the vomiting center within the brain. And this vomiting center then produces the nausea and vomiting. Vomiting center can also be equipped with the other types of receptors like the cholinergic receptors such as muscarinic acetylcholine receptors and histamine receptors such as H1 receptors. Now, phenothiazines primarily block these D2 receptors present on the chemoreceptor trigger zone, thereby they inhibit the emetic response. And phenothiazines can also block the cholinergic receptors as well as the histamine receptors on the vomiting center, thereby they further produce the anti-emetic action. Third type of action shown by the phenothiazines is the anticholinergic action. Phenothiazines can inhibit the muscarinic acetylcholine receptors, thereby they produce few of the actions like dry mouth, blurred vision, constipation and urinary retention. All of these can be observed as the side effects of phenothiazines because of their anticholinergic action. And fourth type of action of phenothiazines is antihistamine action. Allergic conditions can stimulate the mast cells, so the mast cells are going to release one of the important mediator, histamine. Now this histamine can stimulate the vomiting center, thereby it can produce the nausea and vomiting. So two of the phenothiazines like promethazine and prochlorperazine can also act as antihistamines, thereby antagonize the histamine action on the vomiting center and act as antiemetics. And other actions of the phenothiazines. Phenothiazines can block 5-HT receptors, which increases the weight gain. So weight gain is one of the side effects that can be observed with the phenothiazines. How these drugs are used? These drugs can be used as antipsychotics, antiemetics, and it can also be used to treat the severe anxiety and agitation. So that's why these drugs are called as major tranquilizers. They can increase the calmness in the patient and they can increase the sedation in the patient. So one of the drug, chlorpromazine, can be used to treat the severe anxiety and agitated state in the patients. And these drugs can also be used to treat the motor tics and involuntary movements. Again, one of the drug, flufenazine, can be used to inhibit these involuntary movements as well as the motor tics in the patients. One of the main clinical use of phenothiazines is they are used as antipsychotics. Drugs like chlorpromazine, flufenazine, thiorazine, and so many drugs are used as antipsychotics. So these drugs mainly act as antagonists on the D2 receptors, which are more abundant in mesolimbic and mesocortical pathways. But one of the limitations of these drugs is that they does not show any action on D1 and D4 receptors. For example, chlorpromazine blocks mainly D2 receptors, which is a typical antipsychotic, whereas clozapine, which is an atypical antipsychotic, can block the D1 as well as D4 receptors. So phenothiazines mainly act on the D2 receptors and they have little action on the D1 and D4 receptors. Because of their more pronounced action on the D2 receptors, they show the more extrapyramidal side effects compared with the atypical antipsychotics. And they are effective against the positive symptoms of the psychosis like hallucinations and delusions, and they are ineffective against the negative symptoms like social withdrawal and decreased emotional response in the patients. So phenothiazines can act as a antipsychotics, but they relieve only positive symptoms with little effect on the negative symptoms. And second important use of these phenothiazines is the antiemetics. So drugs like promethazine, prochlorperazine, and chlorpromazine can be used as antiemetics within this category. Due to their action on the D2 receptors as well as histamine receptors and cholinergic receptors, these drugs show good antiemetic action. They are used to control the severe nausea and vomiting, as well as they are used to control the emesis during the pregnancy. So promethazine is such a drug which is given during the pregnancy. Apart from these two actions, phenothiazines can also be used to inhibit the involuntary movements in the patients, motor tics, as well as to control the severe anxiety and agitation in the patients. So that's about the different clinical use of phenothiazines.